Hey guys, Derek here from Modern Castle. Today, we're diving into our most ambitious video yet. We're on the hunt for the best water pitcher filters. To find the best filters, we're collecting water samples from 10 different brands and sending them off for laboratory testing. First up, we're going to walk through our process for collecting our water samples for lab testing. If you want, you can jump ahead to our laboratory data reports, filter analysis, and top recommendations. Just click the time code on screen now. We've done several water filter tests over the years, including taste tests, strips that test water quality and pH, and TDS tests using an electronic meter. All these tests offered insights, but also weren't perfect. Being able to have water tested in a lab versus scores of potential chemicals, metals, and other contaminants is massively better. And it's allowing us to add a much higher level of objectivity and testing accuracy. SimpleLab provides a third-party testing service called TapScore. They provided us with the water testing kits for free, handled all laboratory testing, and their scientists helped us understand the results. TapScore did not pay or otherwise compensate us in any way for creating this video. If you're interested, we'll have more info about TapScore at the end of the video. Our first step in the process was to find suitably terrible unfiltered water to test on. We started by running laboratory tests on 3 different water samples. The samples were taken from my personal home as well as the home of 2 of my good friends. All the samples were from the Phoenix, Arizona city water taps. The laboratory results showed significant issues with all 3 water samples, but the water sample at my personal home was the worst of the 3. As a result, that's the water sample we decided to use for testing the 10 water filter pitchers. Next, we moved on to a selection of the water pitcher filters we wanted to test. We were primarily focused on selecting filters from the most popular brands. We chose staples like Brita, Pure, and Zero, among other popular choices, including third-party filters from AquaCrest and Amazon Basic. For this video, we only considered water pitcher filters and not inline, fridge, RO, or other filtration types. However, that's something we may do in the future. All the filters used in our testing were brand new, never opened, and never used before. We purchased all the filters and pitchers that were used in this video, except for the Epic, which did send us a free sample for testing. We began testing by preparing each pitcher. We installed the filter and ran several gallons of water through each pitcher. We generally ran more water through each filter than the manufacturer recommends. However, we wanted to stay on the safe side and ensure any residue and other agents were cleansed from the filter before collecting our water samples. With all of our water pitchers prepared, we moved on to the sample procedure. For this, we leaned heavily on the guidance from TapScore. Their laboratory technicians provided us with specific instructions for collecting the samples in a way that would ensure fair testing and get the most accurate results from the lab. We began by filling up a 5-gallon bucket with unfiltered water directly from the sink. We filled the bucket first with our unfiltered water so that each filter would have water from the exact same source. If we were to turn the tap on and off for one sample at a time, it could result in an unfair laboratory comparison since each water sample could be slightly different. We then poured unfiltered water into each water filter pitcher and allowed them to filter the water. Once filtered, we poured the filtered water into the TapScore testing kit vials. Our last step was to simply mail the kits off to the lab and await the results. It took around a week to get our results back from TapScore. For each testing kit, TapScore creates a detailed report and provides a score on a 1 to 100 scale where 99 is the best score possible. Our unfiltered water sample baseline scored a 43 out of 100 points. This put it in the bottom 23rd percentile for city water across the US. The most dangerous contaminants within the water that dragged the score down were chloroform and uranium, both of which are common in the Phoenix, Arizona municipal water system. As a result, water filters that failed to remove the chloroform or uranium scored poorly. Chloroform is a disinfectant byproduct, and uranium is a heavy metal. There were also notable levels of copper, sulfate, and strontium in our unfiltered water samples, in addition to 7 other contaminants. If you'd like to see the full laboratory testing data, we have links in the description to complete reports and a Google sheet that compares the data side by side. One quick note about water sources. City and well water are very different. As a result, they require different tests. The contaminant that TapScore needs to test for in city water is different from what they would test for in well water. our tests were on city water. So if you're wondering why we don't have data on a certain contaminant, that's the most likely reason. Beyond the differences between city and well water, water quality in general is going to be different everywhere. Different states, cities, and homes all have different water quality challenges. Every tap is different, so it's always best to test your tap so you know for sure what's in your water. With that said, let's take a look at the rankings for the 10 water filter pitchers we tested. The best performing water filter was the Water Dropped, followed by Epic Water and Aquacrest holding the number 3 spot. These three showed a significant measurable difference in total filtration performance compared to the rest of the field. In the middle of the pack, we have the Amazon Basic Filter, Brita, Nakey, and Pure. Following them is Zero Water and Soma, and last is the AquaGear, which really struggled. Let's look at why certain filters performed better or worse. One of the most common water contaminants are disinfection byproducts, or DBPs. Water treatment plants add chlorine to kill bacteria in water. However, chlorine can interact with old plumbing and other organic matter in the water. As a result, it can create a disinfection byproduct. Some DBPs are just annoying and might make the water smell or taste weird. However, others are known to cause cancer. Trihalomethanes, or THMs, are a major type of disinfection byproduct. Chloroform is one of four main THMs in U.S. drinking water. Our unfiltered water had 10 parts per billion THMs, all of it being chloroform. The EPA considers anything over 80 parts per billion a federal violation. THMs are found in almost every home in the U.S. that uses city water. Typically, concentrations range from 10 to 40 parts per billion. When it came to removing DBPs from unfiltered water, the Zero Water and Nakey filters were the worst performers. Both reduced DBPs, but they didn't remove them entirely. Both Zero and Nakey failed to remove around 60% of the disinfection byproducts. Considering the fact that DBPs fluctuate often and are particularly high in the summer when utilities add more chlorine to the water, some reduction just isn't good enough. Soma also struggled with removing DBPs. All of the 7 water filters removed 100% of DBPs, resulting in a complete reduction of all THMs. Next, let's talk about heavy metals. Some metals and minerals are helpful and can make the water taste better. However, certain heavy metals are bad for your health and can cause a litany of problems. Heavy metals occur naturally within the source water and can also leach from your plumbing. The unfiltered water sample we tested contained the heavy metals uranium, copper, and strontium. There was no lead in our water. When it came to removing heavy metals, AquaGear was the worst performer. AquaGear reduced but failed to completely remove uranium. In fact, it left 53% of the uranium in the water. In addition, it was also the worst performer when it came to removing copper, failing to remove 12% of the copper. It also had only a modest removal of other heavy metals and made zero reduction in water hardness. A number of filters actually added metals and mineral to the filtered water. Pure, Soma, Brita, and Amazon Basic all added silver to the filtered water. Silver is often used to help keep filters clean of bacteria. Despite the oddity of these filters adding heavy metals, overall, all filters except AquaGear did an excellent job at reducing or removing the two most significant heavy metals, uranium and copper. Next, let's talk briefly about fluoride. There was a significant ongoing debate about the health benefits and risk of fluoride. We won't unpack that debate here, but we do have the lab testing data for fluoride. Zero Water removed 100% of all fluoride. Epic Water, despite claiming it removes 97.8% of fluoride, removed only 66% of the fluoride. Soma, Nakey, Amazon Basic, and Aquacrest removed 33% of fluoride. AquaGear, Pure, Brita, and Water Drop removed 0 fluoride. Next, let's quickly touch on general water parameters, including TDS, pH, alkalinity, and hardness. First, TDS. TDS is the most overused and unsatisfactory indicator of water quality. Low TDS does not indicate safe water any more than high TDS indicates bad water. Bottled mineral water can have a high TDS, while a glass of distilled water with a splash of nail polish remover in it will still have a TDS of 0. In my view, TDS shouldn't be used as a factor in determining the health of the water. Next, pH. pH does not directly impact the health of the water. As a result, it's not a major factor in how TapScore scores water. Alkalinity stabilizes the water's pH. More alkalinity means less pH volatility, which is a good thing. Most of the filters reduce the alkalinity, while zero removed 100% of the alkalinity. Lastly, we have water hardness. Harder water isn't a health concern, but it can cause bad taste, in addition to causing issues with your plumbing. Most of the filters made notable decreases in water hardness. Zero water reduced hardness by 100%. So then, the big question at the end, what is the best water filter pitcher? Based on the laboratory data, it's clear that water drop is the best water filter. It removed 100% of the most dangerous contaminants in the water, uranium and chloroform. In addition, it didn't add any contaminants during the filtration process while removing most other metals, minerals, and salts that were tested. Looking purely at the ranking scores, number 2 is Epic, followed by number 3, Aquacrest. However, the Amazon Basic and Brita filters weren't far behind. Like the water drop, they removed 100% of uranium and chloroform. In addition, they all did an excellent job at removing copper. The few minor failings varied from filter to filter, with Epic missing over 83% of the strontium, all four of them adding manganese to the water, Aquacrest and Brita adding sodium, and Amazon adding silver. However, all of these are fairly minor relative to the more serious health-impacting contaminants. Pure was sort of middle of the road. Pure removed the chloroform and uranium, but added silver, lead, nitrate, manganese, and sodium. Nakey, Zero Water, Soma, and Aquagear all leave much to be desired. Nakey failed to remove 36% of the chloroform. Zero Water failed to remove 60% of the chloroform.
The Soma failed to remove 20% of the chloroform, but for some reason, Soma filtered water showed a tiny increase in two other THM compounds. Silver and sodium also increased across the Soma filtered water. This could be due to Soma's filtration media releasing these trace minerals into the water.
Aquagear was the worst performer by far. While it removed 100% of the chloroform, it failed to remove 13% of copper and 53% of uranium. In addition, the filtration process added sulfate, nitrate, sodium, and chloride to the water. Based on our laboratory findings, I would strongly recommend Water Drop, Epic, Aquacrest, Amazon Basics, and Brita. While most of the other filters did get the water to a significantly safer standard, they still left much to be desired compared to the top performing filters. As you're looking at our results and recommendations, it's important to remember that we only tested a single water sample from a single filter for each brand from a single water source in Phoenix, Arizona. The water in each country, state, city, and home can vary dramatically. In addition, your plumbing, water treatment facilities, how the water interacts with the filter, the time of the year, and other factors can all have an impact on your water. As a result, if we ran these tests with a different water source, the results would be different. So, please keep that in mind as you're considering the right filter for your home, and remember, it's always best to test the water in your home to know for sure what's best. Last but not least, I want to give a big shout out to TapScore. They provided me with all the water testing kits for this video, helped us ensure that our process for collecting the samples created the best possible lab results, and provided an analysis of the data. TapScore did not pay for this video, nor did they require any special mention. Even so, I want to extend my thanks to TapScore for helping bring this video to life. I was really impressed with the overall experience with TapScore. Collecting the samples is fairly easy, especially if you only need to do one or two, and the results you get back from the lab are easy to understand and incredibly detailed. It's not always clear what's in your water, so having a laboratory analysis of the water you're drinking is both really interesting and has the potential to make a significant impact on your health. Before testing, I knew the water in my home wasn't great, but I definitely didn't realize just how bad it was. Having the knowledge from the lab testing has made me consider a full home filtration system and always ensure the water I'm drinking or cooking with has been filtered. If you're interested in lab testing your water, I highly recommend TapScore. We've got a link in the description if you want to purchase. Well, guys, that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you're interested in purchasing any of the water filters we tested in today's video, we've got links in the description. If you've got questions or comments, please drop those down below. Make sure to like, subscribe, and visit us over at moderncastle.com. As always, thank you so much for watching.